Hey guys, and welcome to another video. This video will be episode 28 of my Resident Rise Let's Play. And before I get started, I quickly want to show you guys this. I have no idea who actually put this in my base, but thank you, I guess. Basically what it is he left. I seriously have no idea who it is. I already asked Echo and he said it wasn't him, so yeah, thanks if you're watching and playing on the server for whoever put this in my base. But basically what he did is he gave me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 biofuel generators and 2 furnace generators, and he said put milk in the biofuel generators. And he even got myself a proto gun. Awesome. I'm a potato. Wow. 3 proto gun pedestals? What? Seriously? Did I just get 3 of those? Huh, well, loot glitch. Well, that's nice. I'm not sure who ever gave it to me, but, yeah, thanks a lot, actually. yeah. So, that kinda shocked me into getting this episode. But, what I want to do today is, well, I'm planning either on doing some more, hi Rich. On getting a better power system going besides this little setup, and also setting up this thingy, and doing quite a lot of tweaks to my base and a new little system to make something to do with blocks and such. So yeah, it would be cool. So I think what would be the best gift is I would first put this thingy to use, the biofuel generator, and I have still no idea how I would use it. But I guess it wouldn't be too hard of a setup. So let's see, can I do something in these walls? No, I cannot. Then what I'll guess I'll need to do is break in a place right here. Because if I want to use these biofuel generators, I will need myself a way to get milk from cows. And of course, I want to get it automatically. So yeah, that would be quite cool. So yeah, get this out of my way. Then what I would like to get is a rancher, and I'm not sure if I already have one, but... Oh, I do. Nice. I believe... Puppycocks... Yeah, Puppycocks once gave me one, or he had like a massive loot chest with stuff, and he basically said like, hey Gorge, here, you go, pick something from this chest, whatever you want. And I picked some very small of these Mine Factory Reloaded machines. So that's nice. Yeah. So let's make this room a bit bigger and put a torch or two inside of this room if I can find my torches. I have no idea why I got them right there. Nice, nice. Then what I'll do is let me quickly clean this up, get myself some cows in here, and I'll be right back. Okay, there we go. I made myself a very little pen so I can put these cows in here. So all I really should need to do now is get myself the cows. And let's see, where is my... Don't I have it there? Oh, yes I do. My golden lasso. Let me quickly get up there. I don't think that using mushrooms will be a problem at all. So I might as well use those since I got those near my base anyway right now. So that should be cool. And I won't need too much anyway, so yeah, let's see. If I would put one mushroom in here, then what I can do is quickly set up this thingy. So basically what I will need to do is make this thing loop around a bit. So yeah, basically like it will be generating its own power, mostly. Hopefully that works. So yeah, where do I want to put these? I guess I'll put them right there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Then what I can do is get some fluiducts, sorry. And I should really make some more soon, but for now these will suffice, I guess. And then these, one more. Then these, let's see, redstone energy thingies. Quickly put this there. And apparently these things will run off milk. So if I get one bucket to kickstart this... I already have one bucket of milk. And is it generating like lots of power? Bit of power? Any power? Please say it's actually doing anything. And it's even producing quite a decent amount of power actually. It doesn't seem to be generating any power whatsoever. If I place this cow a little bit closer... it just produced something. Oh. Darn, that's mushroom soup. Wait. Huh, what do you know? Even mushroom soup works. What do you know? That's nice. Then I can break this. Put this in here and there should go some of those mushroom soup in this thingy soon. I didn't even know that actually worked. Nice. Learning more stuff every day. Then I'll put two in here so it looks a bit more nice. And it should be quite nice. Then I'll probably also need one of those dimensional transceivers to add to my power system. But, yeah. I'm now generating power with mushroom soup. That's quite awesome. And how much do these things actually generate? It doesn't say that. I'll guess something like, 80 retrons flux per tick or something. I don't have one of those thingies on me right now. Let me quickly get one. Dimensional transceiver. I keep forgetting the real name. And, already have the materials. Nice. And now what I should be able to do is simply put this here and make like a private line, soup generation. Just because I can. Private channel, add, send power. Okay, nice. And now this thing should be, working. And wow, it produced a hell of a lot of power right there. Wow. I wish I had one of those empty redstone energy cells so I could actually, see how much it produces. But I guess this will suffice for now. still, thanks to whoever gave me this one. I really appreciate it. Nice stuff. Yeah, quite a lot of power actually, because it's very fast filled this internal buffer up, so I guess that's nice. So let me get right back. Okay guys, let's just say that this is quite a shock, because what I did is I quickly, just to test how much power it's actually generated, I made this thing work on the soup generation, and it is actually producing quite a lot of power. It is taking more than these can output though, but their internal buffer is actually completely filled up. So yeah, that's quite nice. Too bad, it can't output more than it's currently doing, and I have no idea if that's actually, intended or... something like that. But yeah, if not, if this thing can actually power the setup, that's nice. So now what I want to have set up is I want to start working with a mod that I also used last season, which is basically a great source for power generation, which is big reactors. Yes. I know this thing, the idea was quite nice, but eventually it pretty much, didn't work the way I wanted it to work. So yeah. That means it is time for me to start working on a new setup, which is my big reactor. So, if I look up big reactors, we got two different main components here. The big reactor itself and the big turbines. And the big turbines is one of the main setups that I want to go for eventually. So, that would mean that I need to change up a few things, but, it will be worth it, hopefully. And then also make a little bit of a different design that I used last season. I'm thinking or highly considering doing the same setup that Eco used. So yeah, that could be quite nice. So before I do that, I need to get myself a bunch of this graphite. So I need a bunch of charcoal, and I believe I got myself a bunch of that from my tree farm. That's nice. So let me quickly get this processing, make a little design for how I want my big reactor to be laid out completely and everything. and then I'll be right back. Okay guys, so I just quickly had a little talk with Eiko on the server, and basically talking about his design and thinking about what I should do, and I came to a conclusion that I want to immediately hop to the turbine stage instead of waiting for the cyanide. I traded some cyanide with him. Well, he gave me two stacks of cyanide for 2 stacks of fellurium, so that's nice. So first thing I will need is some reactor casings. I have no idea exactly how much I will need, so yeah. All I know is that I will be most likely replicating most of Eiko's design, so because, well, his design just worked incredibly nice and pretty much just the way that I wanted it to work. So let's see, this thing is 4x4, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4, then I'll put this reactor right here. His one was 7x7, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 3 blocks tall. And that's just 7 blocks wide, so that's 1, 2, torch it up, that's not a torch, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, there we go. And also quickly turn this thingy on again. So yeah, I think that once I actually got this entire thing set up, that I will be pretty much set for power wise, because, well, this thing just generates a bunch of water and steam and everything that has to do with it, so that's quite nice. So let's see, the main design will be something like this, I believe. Simply the flooring. I have exactly, really no idea how much yellowium I really have. So yeah, that could be an issue, but it'll work out. So I need 7x7, 94, I need 50 pieces of this stuff again. So that should be quite easy to do. That's 40 and 50. Nice. Then I need some yellowium fuel rods. I believe 9 to be precise. Then I will also need some control rods. Control rods. Oh, those need reactor casings. So let me do this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And that will mean I need a few more of these. Nice. And then I will also need, let's see, a fluid port, no, reactor access port, reactor power tap. I don't think I will need a power tap. I will do need a reactor controller, of course. And then some reactor glass. Oh, and I need more glass for that stuff. How much reactor casings did I put in my system? Oh, one more. This will probably not be enough, so let's see if I put this thing all together. This episode will also probably be a little bit longer than most other episodes that I have, because I want this thing to be finished this episode. So yeah, it should be quite nice. At least for those that like longer episodes, of course. Then put this together. And I will need these furowatts in right there. A reactor controller right there. And the control rods right there. Nice. Then I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 more glass. Should be not too difficult. And a lot more of these casings. So let's see. Glass. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then the rest will be my casings. There we go. Then I'll put that thingy in last. And then what I need to do is simply fill this area in for now. And right there. And if I put this thing down, it should turn into a reactor. Yes, it is. Awesome. That's just what I wanted to see happen. So, the only thing that I do need to add is a sort of liquid in this thing to make this thing actually work the way I wanted it to. And there are quite some nice liquids in here, but I believe Eco is using Resonant Ender, which might as well be a good option. So, yeah, I'll still need to think about that. So, let's see. Now I will need a... I've actually no idea what things I will need to put on this thing. I would assume access ports. And for that I need 2 chests. And some of this stuff. Say 1 to get the water in and 1 to get it the steam out. And then I guess that's it, actually. Nice. Because this thing, I believe, won't be generating power, but only pure steam. So that's quite nice. Now what I can do is, let me break in the sides. Then, let's say, this one, access port. Let's see, set this mode to inlet mode. And set this thing to outlet mode. And now, hopefully this thing will be a liquid working thingy. Oh wait, no, it's not. Okay, let me quickly check on Eco's build and I'll be right back. Ah, I know what I did wrong. I need these coolant ports. And for that I will need 2 more casings. Nice. Luckily it's not really an issue because I needed those water ports anyway. So yeah, that's not really anything that's bad. So what I can do is I'll put this right there. Then these can go right here. Reactor coolant port right there and there. Turn this to output, I guess. Then these 2 ports can go right there. And now, yep, as you guys can see, this thing is now in basically output steam mode, which is nice and just what I wanted to have happen. So now what I need is a way to generate myself a bunch of water. And I'm not even over-exaggerating when I say a bunch of water. And the best way for that is extra utilities in my way. In my opinion. So if I look up extra utilities. Yeah, basically what I will need is some transfer pipes, transfer node liquids, and a bunch of these mining and speed upgrades. So let me quickly get that and I'll be right back. Okay guys, so I think this is working how I wanted it to. I placed myself 10 mining upgrades and 10 speed upgrades, and these mining upgrades aren't, you know, too expensive, but they require some iron. And this thing should be producing a bunch of water now, and once I turn it on, steam. But for now, I have no way of actually using the steam yet. So that is what I need to do for my next project. If I look up big turbines, or big reactors, sorry. I already spoiled what I want to make, and get to my crafting system. Now I need to make myself this turbine system, and for that I will need myself, well, a bunch of cyanide. So yeah, when I say a bunch, I mean over, yeah, a lot of that stuff. I'm not even sure if this will be enough or anything, but yeah, I like to build the way I simply do stuff. So, and for a turbine controller, I will need plutonium, which I will need plutonium dust, which requires... Oh wait, that's one of those other thingies, right? Yeah, I know what it is. Let's see. I will need some of this stuff. We'll only need, I believe, 1 to put the steam in. Then I need 1 rotor bearing. And for that I will need some of this. And I will need a bunch of these anyway. Say 10. Then I need 1 rotor bearing. So that's only 1 of those. Then I need, let's see, I got those, got 1 of those. Power port. Ah, also quite important, a way to output all my power. And yeah, a turbine controller, which I'll make in just a sec. Then for each or turbine, I will need twice as much of those things that I'm currently crafting. I already forgot the name. So let's make 16 of those. Nice. So now what I can do is hop in here. And I'm really doing this all basically on what I think would work. I don't like to check up stats too much because, you know, I like to do stuff how I go and test them while I'm doing that stuff. So yeah, that's pretty much the way I roll. So let's see. First of all, I will need myself a bunch of these housings put down. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. A bit more. I need it to be this big, I think. Nice. And also, I think, fill this in. Then right there. No, I don't think this will work, actually. I believe the biggest one, or the smallest one, has to be a 5x5. So I need to make this thing actually even taller. Like I said, I'm learning as I'm going. So yeah. And this thing... this thing didn't even work the way I wanted it to anyway. So that's cool. Break this all. And the good thing about having this right next to my turbine is I will not need to mess around with how to output all of the steam or everything. Well, only a little bit of a distance, but not too much, luckily. So it will save myself quite a lot of effort too. And well, my inventory is quite full. So let's see, I can put this right here, then this, quickly dump some of this stuff in my bag, which I got for a reason, luckily. Nice, then my turbine rotor can go on that side, and then this fill this thingy in. Then this wall needs to be sealed in, absolutely. Like I said, I will probably need a few more of these pieces soon, but yeah, I'll get that in a minute then. Then a fluid port right there, I think. And a power port, I'll put that right there for now. Then this can go all right there. Let me quickly get a few more of these pieces and might as well get myself some plutonium and get this thing all ready. Okay, got myself a few more of this stuff going. So then I'll put this controller right in the middle. Then this stuff needs to go right there. Break this. I'm not sure how much of this stuff I will need, but I'll probably use quite a lot of it. And right there. These things also need to be filled in. Nice. Then what I can do is put these shafts right around here. And now what I need to do is get myself some sort of fancy metal. And if I quickly look it up what the metal effects are, because I got myself a little sheet up, which is made by a friend on the server, Sace. And he basically did a lot of testing and see how much it all works and how much each thing produces. So, the most expensive one is Endurium, which I have no intention of using yet. Tartarite, don't have that. Titanium, Platinum, Flingel, Hedrod, Flux, Electrum, Electrum, Quicksilver, Oraculum, and then Gold. And quite a lot more stuff. But the way that I think I want to go is with Gold. Since Gold is, you know, not too expensive. Well, it's Gold, but yeah. So, I need, let's see, how much Gold do I actually have? Gold. I need in total, I believe it's 16 pieces. So that's one more. Yeah, like I said, going to, you know, just try a lot and learning the way I go. So I have no idea exactly how much this all will work. So I believe what I need to do is put this right there, surrounding this bearing on the other side. And then fill this thing in with glass. Oh, Oh, wait, no. Oops. Getting one important step. Adding the rotor blades. Also, you know, when building a turbine could be quite useful, of course. So let's see. I made myself a few pieces too much. One set. Then I'll guess what I can do is put this right there. I'm not sure if that actually matters or not, but I'll see. So let's see. Hopefully this thing does form a multi-block structure, and if it does, is it? Ah, yes, it is. Awesome. Woohoo, that is just what I wanted to see. Nice. So, now what I, in theory, only should need to do is hook these things up together and throw some fuel in this thing. So, let's see. For some reason I got an idea that fluid ducts won't even transmit even close to the amount of power this thing needs to output, but I guess we'll see in just a sec. And this thing needs to be turned on. Active. Now what I can do is get myself at least one piece of yellorium. And activate reactor. Okay, so is it outputting steam already? Apparently not. Casing heat. Okay, it should be outputting already. It's already outputting steam, yes. And this thing is speeding up. Awesome. This is just what I want to see happen. This thing is heating up. Let's see if I add a bit more yellorium. Will that make a difference or anything? Core heat. Casing heat. Oh, yes, it does. Nice. Core heat is transferred to the casing. Nice. Which is pretty much what I want to have. And wow, am I seriously using that much power? Wow. And, oh wow, I'm currently producing over... Damn, that's quite a lot of power. let me turn this off. Turn this thingy off for now. Holy hell, that's a lot of power. Let me just tell you that I did not expect this thing to output this much power that fast. And apparently the only issue that I'm currently having is that I'm already running out of water. Well, didn't know that would happen. So yeah, what I guess I'll do is let me quickly find a good way to store this power for now. And then what I'll do is, wow, I'm still stunned how much power this produces. Get a few upgrades that I can put in this thingy and I'll be right back. Okay guys, so I quickly added 10 more of each upgrade in this thing, and it seems to be keeping up quite nicely now with the water, so that's good. The steam is also outputting at a very fast rate, and this thing is just producing an immense amount of power. I mean, over 19,000 redstone flux per tick. I mean, that's just insane in my opinion. Not complaining, but yeah, pretty insane. I do need to, you know, think of a way to actually dump the power right now, because right now I'm only wasting all of this stuff. So let's do that. Also need to turn this down a little bit because I'm using, you know, I don't need this thing to run too much. But if the optimal speed is 900 RPM, but I'm not exactly sure, so I'll need to do some testing with that. All I need to know is that how does it work if I output all the energy that I need. So let's see, now what I will need is another dimensional transceiver. And I need an Eye of Ender, nice. Okay, so now I need some better ways of storing power. And I believe one very nice way is an ultimate energy cube. These things are, well, not too expensive, but they do take quite a lot of diamonds. But yeah. They're still quite nice and they produce a lot of power. So so I won't bore you guys too much. I'll quickly craft a... Well, I won't say a bunch because these things are very expensive. But let me craft a couple of those things up and I'll be right back. Okay guys, I'm quickly made myself... Well, quickly, took a little bit of time. 5 Ultimate Energy Cubes, and I still had some of those Ultimate Universal Cables from that build. So yeah, this is quite nice. If I did it correctly, those things are all put to output to the bottom right now. So that's quite nice. And I added one more little setup right here, which is my turbine setup, and only dedicated to my turbine. So let's do some testing. Now what I need to do is get myself at least one more of those transceivers. And for that I need one more blaze. Thingy, Eye of Ender. Or two. And I need more of this stuff. And don't I have one more in there? No, I do not. Darn, why do I keep forgetting that I need to prepare some of this stuff? Because I will be cutting way too much into this episode. Well, what I can do though is activate this. This thing is building up heat very fast. And how heavily irradiated the core is. High levels of radiation reduce fuel burn up. Oh well. This thing is producing way too much steam, so I need to turn this thingy on. Now it has a way to output its steam. And it's losing the heat. I'm not sure if this is actually dangerous, this thing heats up. So yeah. Now this thing will be speeding up quite rapidly, which is just what I wanted to. The RPM is going up. The energy output is, of course, even better, going up. And hopefully, once I got this thing set up, I will never, ever, ever need to change anything in this setup ever again. Because, well, besides that, I will need myself a bunch more Eulorium, because I'll probably eat through this stuff. And, you know, for that, I will also need myself a better way of generating or getting resources. But that'll have to wait for a little bit later. So, yeah, let's see if this thing is actually running at max efficiency, and then I will be able to wrap up this episode. So, this thing is already at max. It's not having too much interesting stuff yet. This thing is outputting all its steam through that iron duct, which is nice. I didn't know it could do all of that through one. And this thing is almost at its maximum speed, I guess, because it's already having some trouble. And those things are already rolling, so that's good. Using... Yeah, it's around 100. Yeah, thingies. Rotor blades can only fully capture energy from 25 buckets of fluid per blade. Efficiency drops. Yeah, I have no idea exactly. But it's nice and it's slowing down. So, yeah, I think I can safely say that this setup will produce around 19,000 redstone flux per tick. And wow, look at this thingy. This thingy, I believe, produce or I can store 52 million redstone flux, and well, it's evenly distributing all its power, so yeah, you can safely say that this thing is producing a massive amount of power. And if I would put this to, let's say, a quarry, it would run like, well, like incredibly fast, I should say. And yeah, I'm just so proud of this thing. I've never actually built anything this big or actually a big turbine before. So yeah, I guess this is quite nice. So let me quickly put some glass. Nah, let me quickly get some other glass. If I have some in here. Borderless glass, that's the one. And some torches. Nice. So I can also keep an eye on how this thing is running all the time. And put some torches in here so it looks a bit nicer. And not on that. So yeah, this thing is pretty awesome. Is it stalling? Yeah. So it's producing 19,125 redstone flux per tick. Awesome. So yeah, like I said, I think this would be a good wrapping up point for episode 28. I hope you guys enjoyed. I'm pretty satisfied with how I managed to build this thing. I know I'm a bit over time of my usual episodes, but you know, you guys deserve a longer episode once in a while. So, yeah. Thanks for watching, guys. Please leave a rating. If you have any suggestions or ideas or anything, feel free to let me know down below in the comment section, or of course, send me a little message. I appreciate it always. So, yeah. Thanks for watching. Please leave a rating, and hope to see you guys all next time.